Hello, I'm here. Okay, we're in the fly-by-wire A320. See? Told you. We're gonna put a flight plan in we're in St. Louis right now. And we're going to let's go to Columbia, Missouri, where the college is, and we'll give that a try. So I need to open up the Simbrief to put it in, and all right, and we'll go to the dispatch system. Do a new flight, and we'll call this flight, let me scoot back here a little bit. Foxtrot, uniform, kilo. And we'll say 999, and we're at KSTL at St. Louis, and we want to go to Columbia, Missouri, where the Columbia College is, and let's see if I can find the IKO for Columbia. Missouri Airport. KCOU. All right. KCOU. KCOU. And I'm just going to say no alternate. Nothing ever goes wrong. And then we'll select the A20N with this fly-by-wire A32NX, all versions. Cost index is 10. We're going to, this is a little extra fuel here. We'll go to P05. I don't want runway analysis. And then the payload, we'll say auto. Yeah, that sounds fine. Okay. Let's, oh, the runways 29 and 31. Let me see if I can do that to 30 left here. Okay, and let's create it. Generate the flight. That looks good. There's our flight plan there. And we'll leave that there. Just reduce this down. And close that. Alright, now. What am I thinking about? Oh. I don't really need to do this, but I'm just going to do it. This brings in the Simbrief flight plan. But the fly-by-wire does a good job at it, so... Okay. Now, let's get inside. We'll do it cold and dark. Looks like we're at C30, gate 30. Nice and quiet in here. Alright, we need to get a power. And turn on the... Oh, it says it's available. That's interesting. External power. So we'll turn it on. And we'll turn on our two batteries. Battery one, battery two. And we will leave the... let's do the oxygen supply. Ground control. We'll turn on our ADIRS. Let those start locking on. Okay, this, we need fuel for the APU. And I'll turn on the APU bleed. And also we want our beacon light on. Put that to auto. And we'll get ready for the passengers. Set the seat belts and things on. I don't know. We'll put that up for detect ice. Alright. And, see if that's gonna kick our, APU on. APU. Okay, yeah, it's climbing up. We can clear those, all this here. The IRS is in alignment. 6 minutes. Seatbelt lights on. No portable devices is on. APU bleed is on. TCAS is in standby. So we'll go down and turn it on. This is TCAS here. Auto. ABV, and we'll put this on transmit and receive. Okay. And when we go to take off, we're going to need the, this goes up and down, we're going to arm it. We're gonna lock the cockpit before people get on so they can't come in here and hurt us. This is a predictive wind shear. This is our parking brake is on. And floodlight, I don't need the floodlights. I can turn this on. No, I want the panel lights on all the way. And see, we'll get these all the way up. These light up these two screens. Alright. Now let's go over to the our fly pad. Okay, and we'll import the Simbrief data, which it looks like it's already in there. It's a little under an hour flight. Okay. Since we got ground power, let me go ahead and turn that on. I wonder if it's gonna drop it on us though. Let's see if the APU is still running. Yeah, still running. So I won't argue with that at the moment. After that gets aligned, we'll get our radar there. And we'll go over here and go to the fuel, and we'll download it from Simbrief, and we'll start filling it. It's doing it in real time, so take a while. This is board our passengers. We don't have the oh, okay, yeah, that's just the seats are gonna fill up and services, fuel, payload, pushback. We can get the jet bridge pulled up to us. Let me open up the forward door. Is that the same one? Yeah, and then bring the jet bridge up. Up. Okay. That looks good. There's our ground power unit truck. And we'll do the get the baggage on board. Hmm. baggage truck. We'll skip the fuel truck because I'm already filling it up. Looks like it's probably full. Real tiny falls. Stops with a half a. Half a whatever that is. Okay. And then the people, we can start bringing them on. We'll do it in real time. Looks like our IRS is locked in. These are from these here. Let me turn them off. Got them on over there too. Alrighty. Check these, make sure they're on right. Yes, they are. Okay. I can see that all right. Let's do the flight plan while the people are getting on. Put it in the FMC. I'll request it. Okay. Go to the next screen. Might not do this yet. Let's see. No, it's got. Let's try it. Let's see if it fills in there. No, out of range, so. I was thinking that might not be good yet. Let's hit performance. Clear that. This is for the flaps for takeoff. We'll have them on the first setting. And then the computer figures this stuff out, so I just push it, it fills it in. Oh. Initialize weight. I missed something here. Not allowed. at to data link status. Okay, says it's available. That's the air traffic controller menu. I don't really need that right now. Initial data request. Let's see if we have enough here now. It's not going to be good. It's out of range. Okay. Performance. One. And then we'll clear that. Initialize weight and CG. That's the it. Okay, here we go. Well, wait, that's where I was. Initialize weight and CG. Performance data. Did it finish filling up the people? Maybe not. They're still loading the people. Getting closer. So that's probably what's happening. And the fuel's loaded up. Get all the people on board and It's getting close. Yeah, we need this. That's what's going on. The zero fuel weight and zero fuel weight center of gravity. One more person.
Boarding completed.
Okay, good deal. Now let's go back and see if I can do this again. Clear it, and then we'll hit. That's different. It should work now. And fuel planning.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the flight deck, on behalf of myself, your captain, the first officer, and cabin crew, I'd like to take this time to welcome you aboard our flight. We're just wrapping up some paperwork up front here and waiting to see final numbers from the ground crew, then we'll be on our way. Flight attendants will be coming through the cabin shortly with a very important safety briefing. We do ask that you give them your crew
and will be able to review the safety operations of this
aircraft. We do appreciate your business having you aboard this flight. If there's anything we do to make your flight any more enjoyable, please don't hesitate to ask. Welcome aboard.
123, 124, and 128. Okay. Let's go to the next, our climb, 250. And this is our cruise. Descent. Okay, this we need this. This is our barometric pressure, temperature, and our compass and wind direction. I can get this right over here. And it's for our destination. So 30, 25. That's our inches of barometric pressure, and the temperature is negative 12 degrees centigrade. That's cold. Okay, negative 12 degrees. All right, and our compass and wind speed 260, coming from 260 degrees at 11 knots. So 260 degrees at 11 knots. Okay. All right. And next phase. I think we're pretty much done here. Okay, now let's go to the flight plan. All right. St. Louis is our departure. So we select St. Louis departure, and I picked 30 left, I think, didn't I? Let's look. Yeah, 30 left. Okay. And let's see if we have a SID. That's a departure, like a route. Okay. BRAC 5. There it is right there. Okay. And then, was there an HLV there? Yes, there was. Okay. So we'll choose that transition HLV. And we'll put that in the flight plan. And we're going here, so that's our arrival. And at 31, okay, so, well, that's a, holy cow, that's a short runway. We'll try it, huh? Wait, oh, where's ILS? Okay, here we go. No. ICOU 110.70. Let's try this. Okay. That's changing my plans. Let's say no star. So enter it. Let's turn on the, so we can see the plan on our radar here. Okay, we're at the beginning of St. Louis, and 10s look good. So let's look for any discontinuities. One. Okay. HLV, and there's a flight plan. Discontinuity. We'll clear that. Okay. It should be filling in. There we go. Okay. See, I goofed it up with that change in the plan there. Well, it's like I don't know whether we can get there from here, but we'll do it anyway. I'll figure something out. Let's see what our barometric pressure is here. We're 30-something. 30.25, okay. So we gotta make this 30.25 here. And this needs to be 30.25 also. Changes the elevation. I'm going to push the B just to see. Yeah, it stayed there. Good. Okay. B is kind of a hot key. It automatically sets the barometric pressure. Let's ask for a pushback. Mm-hmm. I want ground. Where's ground control? Gosh. Gosh, gosh, gosh. Ground control to Major Tom. Okay. I guess I'll try and use this one to push off. Let's get the jetway off. I think it's still hooked up. Yep. Can I get rid of it here? No. It's not giving me any options to. Okay. And services. Let's do the jetway. And we can get rid of the ground power unit too. You can see the exhaust coming out the tail there from that APU and a little motor back there. Okay, now maybe they'll let me call for a pushback. No? Still nothing here. So we'll go back in and do it this way. Okay. Let's go backwards. Oh, call tug. Okay. There it is. It scoops it up and raises the wheel. Okay. And then we'll let me go back in normal. Okay. We're gonna go backwards. Take the brake off. Yeah, we'll start going backwards first. Then take the brake off. Okay. Go back in towards the right. The tug. Okay, we gotta start the engine. The big engines. Gas for the left engine. Get that one for the heck of it. And we'll go down here. Left engine and crank it. I can hear it starting. Gotta get that up to about 69. Also, we need our flaps at 1, so I'll move our flap. Then you'll see it expand out here. Flaps and slat. Okay. Let's go start the right engine. Actually, I didn't turn the gas on. Okay. Mm-hmm. for takeoff. We want the spoilers armed and the brake on max for auto in case we need to shut down. We have V1, V2. Okay, V1, V2, VR. This is the rotate. V1 is, if we get up to V1, there's no turning back. You right, have to take off. Okay. Engines are up. 65. Usually they're a little higher, but that's all right. And let's go up. We'll turn the APU off. Turn on this heat there. Turn the APU generator off. And I want to, I got to shut off the ignition, put it to normal. Ready. Usually I have to push this to get to cabin ready, but it's all right. And takeoff configuration is just okay. Everything is good. So we're good there. APU went off, so that's good. We can look through fuel, hydraulics, our electrical, pressurization, bleed. How the engines, air conditioning, doors are all closed, wheels are down, and flight controls. Okay, that all looks fine. All right, let's go back to the flight plan here. Let's take this to that noise abatement. Okay. to use it and see if there's any. Nope. Okay. Pushing the take the brake off and. Hopefully they're keeping an eye on us. We're going to go to 30 left. Looks like a plane's coming in. Another one coming in on the right, going to runway 29. That flag is, that windsock looks like it's, blowing the wrong way. No, it's blowing the right way. I thought it was going. Down. Back the 180 degrees. Alright. We'll, stop and ask permission to take off. On 30 left, okay. Ain't that something? Here's tower. Let's see. Sometimes I think it's out of sync. Doesn't work right. I see a plane out there, but. Get out here and get out of his way. Okay, let's get full throttle. Back, bring the gear up, and we'll bring the throttle back, and that's all right. Gotta get the autopilot on. There it goes. Thank you. We're doing our noise abatement, huh? Get it dialed in for 10,000. Let me go up this way. Okay. Yeah, we'll hit that. We'll go into a climb. This will go up to... It's on auto throttle. Auto throttle came on by itself. And then I had to roll back the climbing up. We're going up 10,000. I had to bring this back to climb. And that's where the auto throttle works at. We can put the spoilers. Actually, I can just move this and then it goes down by itself. You know, 14,000 feet according to this. Let's go up to 14,000 like there. But we changed it to 2, I think. Yeah, 2. Okay. Let me look at something here. Columbia Regional. Approach 2. Okay. ILS. This is our frequency for the ILS 110.7. Let's see if it's in here yet. 110.70. Okay, so we want, what was that other, we'll go back and look at it. ICOU. 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 I see. Oh, you, and I guess I separate it with that, and then the frequency is 110.70. Okay. 10.70. All right, let's make sure. Yeah. And then let me put that in there. Format error. Maybe I don't put that in there. Was it I C O U? Hmm. 110.70. Ah. I see. Oh, you. Oh, it worked. I only had to put the ICOU in there. Okay. 110.70. Cool. That's our ILS, our landing system frequency, that I was looking up over here. And let's go back to flight plan. Oh, we should be descending. It's a short flight.
From the flight deck, ladies and gentlemen, as you may have noticed, we have begun our initial descent down to our destination. Now would be a good time to wrap up any business we need to take care of as we prepare for our approach. If you are up, once you return to your seat, we ask that you remain seated until you have left flight safety on the gate. By the fans, please prepare the cabin for left.
That's for the ILS constraints on altitude. Let's turn on the approach. So we can switch this. put the flaps down.
$2,500.
See that flip over there? Yep. Approach. Lining up. We just gotta come in left to right for the runway. I don't have it set to 3,000, so. Arm the spoilers. Landing gear, cabin check, full flaps. Cabin check. Put the landing lights on. Okay. Landing gear down.
Flight attendants, please be careful.
This don't look good. Gosh darn it. Didn't pick up the glide slope to get down. Missed approach. Okay. the gear up. Turn the approach off. We'll go up to 4,000. Expedite. Okay, I'm going to bring the flaps. Autopilot went off. Let's see if I can. Yeah, push that. And then the, try that. Okay. How's our fuel? Oh, we got a lot on the outside wings. Okay. Alright, the opposite of 2 is 20. So 200. So let's do a heading F200. Too far. The heck? Oh, transfer. How do I get the thing to transfer? Oh no. I thought it automatically would transfer. If you crossfade on. Cross feet on. Okay, and then hydraulics. Power packs off. Why they all go off? Oh, we're going down. Ouch. Didn't work out very good.